Hi, my name is Zoran Horvat. In this video, I will show you how to use record types in C# and a few reasons why you should do that. You may know me from Plural site, where I have, I don't know, some 60 hours of video courses published. There are also some video courses I have published at Udemy. If you like what you see here, you can visit me on those platforms and learn more. Now about records. I will start from an empty application and try to model, say, a person. I will create a new file and declare the record there. It begins similar to what you would normally do with a class. You would declare a class, but here you will declare a record using the record keyword, which is new in C# 9. Then you would declare public properties like string, birth date. This date only type is new in .NET 6. We were waiting for it for about 20 years or something like that. Anyway, this is the entire declaration of a record which exposes two public properties, name and birth date. If you had anything more to add, you could add a body here. Otherwise, what you cannot do with the class, you can just close the record declaration with a semicolon and it's done. This is the new type. It is modeling a person with two properties, with two public properties, and it is implementing value typed equality. What can we do with this record? We can instantiate it like any other object by calling its constructor. There will be a constructor with two parameters, a string and a date-only object. And I don't know, we can print it. Here it is. Besides constructor properties and other things and value typed equality, records also implement a nice to string implementation, which is helpful in debugging. What else is there? Let me show you. I will create a few person objects. There will be some duplications if you observe closely. There are a couple of repeated objects here. And if I print it out, total number of items here and total number of distinct items in the array, you would notice that distinct operator is working just as you would like it to do. Here is the output. There are total 5 objects and 3 distinct ones, so there is duplication. And distinct operator worked very well. It would not do that if it were a class, just a regular class. Record is also a class, but on a regular class, distinct operator would not work out of the box because classes have reference-typed equality implemented, and records have value-typed equality. They are comparing components, the name and that date-only component. Besides that, you can use records as keys in indexed structures like dictionaries, hash sets. You can use them in group by, and for example, select how many duplicates of each person there are in this array. So I will print those out. Let's see. Yes, here you can see that there are 2 copies of Joe and 2 copies of Jane. So that is the duplication. Record type has discovered equal instances again. But then, what is this record thing? What is this record keyword? It is just a class. There's nothing special in the record type. It is a class. That record with 2 parameters would expose 2 public read-only properties with init-only setters. So besides, beyond construction, there will be no mutation on the object. It would expose a public constructor with those 2 parameters in the order in which they were listed in parentheses. A deconstructor, a very interesting thing. Deconstructor means that you can assign a record object to a tuple with the same components as those in the records declaration. There will be an implementation of strongly typed iEquotable. Obviously, the equals, strongly typed equals, then the weakly typed equals, then get hash code, and that nice to string override, which is, again, useful in debugging. All that, all this code you see, some 20 lines and more of code, fits into a single keyword, record. That is the principal reason why you should use that. Don't write those 20 lines of code over and over again in every single value typed class in your models. Just use the record keyword. What else can we do with record objects? There is one interesting feature that is non-destructive mutation, which is a novel thing in C#. I mean, it's not so new. We used to implement it ourselves for a decade and more. But records are supporting non-destructive mutation out of the box. How does it work? What if this person, Joe, had a twin brother, Jim? The only thing they differ in is name. You can use the with expression to only change one property. But that doesn't mean that Joe instance will change. No, it will remain the same. It is immutable. A new instance will be created with all the properties copied and only one of them name changed. So Jim will be the same as Joe, and I will print both of them so that you can see Jim will be the same as Joe with only the name changed. You can see that birth date value has been copied. You can, of course, you can list multiple properties in the with expression and change all of them, but everything else will remain the same. It will be copied from the first instance. I will show you why this is important. What if there were the third property in the record? You don't have to copy that new property on your own. With expression will do that for you. It is helping you maintain vertical compatibility between your new and old version of the record, the definition. There's another intermediate step that we might make to help maintain vertical compatibility. Instead of calling the constructor, you may introduce a static factory function. Also, if you wanted to do any validation, this could be the place for it. Back in the consuming code, instead of calling constructors in all the places where you need the object, just call the factory function. Everything will work the same, except that now you can transparently add a new property to the record. Compiler is now reporting an error at a place where constructor was called. Lucky for me, factory function is the only place where I have called the constructor. So, if I added the new property for the nickname, I could now introduce the third parameter to the factory function, static factory, with a default, which is fine, and fix the constructor call. Everything on the calling site will keep working the same because none of these objects knows about the third parameter. But if Joe had a nickname, Pinky, what would be the consequence of that? You see, nothing is read here, nothing is causing compile time errors, but a with expression is now copying the nickname together with the birth date. I was successful, here it is, I was successful in adding the entire new parameter to an entire new component to the record type, and the entire code works correctly still, because none of the objects, nothing in my code knows about the new parameter, about the new component, and yet static factory function and with expression are helping me maintain vertical compatibility and accept the new component in the record without having to change anything in the entire code base. Of course, the piece of code which knows about the new property can utilize it. Besides that, record is just a regular class. You can add anything to its body that you would add to a normal class, like a public method which is doing some arithmetic with the dates, checking whether the birthday has passed already or not, or a method which calculates current age of the person. So anything you need in this record to be operational, just add it, like into a normal class. Do not overdo that. If you need dependencies, services, let alone mutation, then record is obviously not the right thing for you. But for any use where value typed equality is a request, where you are modeling value objects in DDD terms, record is just for you. Use them. We were waiting for records for at least a decade, and here they are. There's no excuse for you to avoid using them in your production code. If you liked this, you can learn more from my Pluralsight videos. These are some of the most prominent courses I have published there. Making your C# code more object-oriented is a lovely one. If you want to receive notifications about new videos, about live coding sessions, subscribe to my channel. And that would be all. Thank you for watching. Thank you for watching and see you soon.